Good morning everyone, let us continue with the multiple pregnancy. First we will talk about the examination of placenta and membrane. So in dizygotic twins there are two placentae. Note here that the singular word is placenta, and when we are talking about two placenta, we will label it as two placentae. So there are two placentae, either completely separated or more commonly fused, at the margin appearing to be one. So this is about 9 out of 10 cases. There is no anastomosis between the two fetal vessels. Each fetus is surrounded by a separate amnion and chorion. Then sex. While twins having opposite sex are almost always dizygotic. So if the twins are of opposite sex, this is the dictum, this is the rule, they are dizygotic twins. The uniovular twins are always of the same sex. If the fetuses are of the same sex and have the same genetic features, so we will call this as dominant blood group, and monozygotic zygosity is likely. A test skin graft, acceptance of reciprocal skin graft is almost a certain proof of monozygosity. So if you want the proof of monozygosity, we have a test skin graft. Then follow-up study between 2 and 4 years is showing almost similar physical and behavioral features. So if there is almost similar physical and behavioral features, monozygosity is very likely. Now this table shows the summary of determination of zygosity. So there are certain things which can differentiate between monozygotic and dizygotic twins. The placenta, the communicating vessels, the intervening membranes, the sex, the genetic features, then skin grafting, and lastly follow-up. So in monozygotic twins, the placenta will be one, the communicating vessels will be present, and the intervening membranes will be two amnions will be there, the sex is always identical, same sex will be there, genetic features will be same. When we are talking about the genetic features, we mean to say about the dominant blood group and the DNA fingerprinting. Then skin grafting is accepted over here, and then there will not be any rejection between the monozygotic twins for skin grafting, and follow-up is usually identical. Then in dizygotic twins, there will be two placenta, communicating vessels will be absent, intervening membrane there will be two amnions and two chorions, sex may be different, and genetic features will differ. Skin grafting, there will be a rejection of the skin grafting, and follow-up will be not identical. So that is the determination of zygosity. So this table is very important to differentiate between monozygotic and dizygotic twins. In India, the incidence is about 1 in 80. Monozygotic twins remains fairly constant throughout the globe, being around 1 in 250. Prevalence of dizygotic twins is related to the race. The frequency is highest among Negroes. So dizygotic twins is more common in Negroes and lowest among Mongols and intermediate among Caucasians. So Indian population comes under Caucasians. Hereditary, it is again your twin pregnancy is hereditary, and usually it is on the maternal side. Advancing age of the mother, maximum being between the age of 30 and 35 years. Now there is the influence of parity on the multiple pregnancy, we can see. So when we are talking about the influence of parity, the incidence is increased with increasing parity, especially from fifth gravida onwards. So twin pregnancy is more common in the as the parity increases. Then iatrogenic, drug used for induction of ovulation. So now this is again more common cause of twin pregnancy, and the most common drug we use is the clomiphene system. Then the next is the superfecundation. Is the fertilization of two different ova released in the same cycle by separate acts of coitus within a short period of time. Then superfetation is the fertilization of two ova released in different menstrual cycle, the nidation and development of one fetus over another fetus, and this is theoretically possible until the decidual space is obliterated by 12 weeks of pregnancy. Then next is the fetus capillaceous, or we can say compresses. So this is a state which occurs if one of the fetuses dies early. The dead fetus is flattened, mummified and compressed between the membranes of the living fetus and uterine wall. So here is the photograph of fetus capillaceous or compresses. You can refer the book, the textbook. They have given a wonderful photograph of fetus capillaceous or compresses. Then the fetus acardiacus occurs only in monozygotic twins. The part of one fetus remains amorphous and becomes parasitic without a heart. Then the next is hydatidiform mole from one placenta, and a normal fetus and placenta have been observed ultrasonographically. Then the next is the vanishing twin. Serial ultrasound imaging in multiple pregnancies since early gestation has revealed occasional death of one fetus and continuation of pregnancy with the surviving one. The dead fetus simply vanishes by resorption. The rate of disappearance could be to the extent of 40%. Now coming on to the maternal physiological changes that occurs during the multiple pregnancy. So when we are talking about the maternal physiological changes during multiple pregnancy, obviously certain logical things are there, that there will be increase in weight gain and cardiac output. Placental volume is, the plasma volume will be more, it is around half the liter more, and there is increase in the alpha fetoprotein level, tidal volume and GFR rate will be more. Then lie and presentations in the twin pregnancy. The most common lie of the fetus is longitudinal, but malpresentations are quite common. The combination of presentation of the fetuses are both vertex will be around in 50% of the cases, the first vertex and second breech 30% cases, first breech and second vertex 10% cases, both breech will be 10% cases, first vertex and second transverse and so on, but rarest one being both transverse when the possibility of conjoint twins should be ruled out. So here we will stop. Thank you very much.